So I'm just going to start to get some bluer tones into some of the faces on this rock to develop the shapes and start to get it feeling a bit more rock-like. More water. So I'm just putting some different subtle or lighter tones to show that this rock has got some different directions of surfaces. Trying to break it up by painting some of these little shapes. Link that into this rock at the back there, which is a bit darker. Drop back into my purples, purpley blues. A little bit of yellow in it. Coming into this rock here, which is quite dark. Kind of comes in and up. And he goes back there. Find it again on this side. Going back to my lighter washes. Some of these slightly more greyer tones on these far rocks. Lots and lots of little rocks back here. Don't really want to try and paint individual rocks as such, just broken colour. To suggest little cracks and crevices in the wash. And then this one's a bit darker up here. Darker rock down there. And then I need a slightly bluer grey on this face here. As it goes into the front of the rock, it gets slightly darker again. So I'll bring that through there. And again into this rock back here. Can have a little bit more tone coming down to where it's in shadow. And then in the shadowy area, a bit more purple and blue. So in here it's going to be very dark behind this nice light bit on the rock here in front. To make that show up a bit better. And this one's casting a shadow down behind this rock. Okay, and a bit of brown now. burnt sienna, I should say. Some orangier tones. Perhaps there's a little bit of that on this rock. Bit of that going up back, link it to those rocks. I feel like I still need a bit more dark in that background, so I'm going to go to my neutral tint colour, which is a very dark, almost black, and then into that I'm going to put a little bit of the lime green, so it's a very dark mix, and I'm going to spray just a bit of water in that top section. And then again, tilt the board down. And then start to wiggle some of these very dark colours into this area. Some more darks in here, perhaps the odd straight or two. Just make this a bit darker. A little bit of dry brushing. And into that I'm going to put some stronger stronger blues, quite a strong blue, like a Windsor blue or a Prussian blue, a phthalo blue, with a little bit of the lemony green in it again. And I'm just going to work that into some of these areas, these darker parts, just to get the colour to have a bit more interest. Break it up a bit. A bit stronger still. A few squiggly marks. My foreground rocks. So through here needs a lot more tone to it. So I'm going to use some Payne's grey and some like a light red, English red type colour. And I'm just going to wet the area a little bit. Just put a bit of water through this section, and start to drop in some of these really dark colours for these rocks. Kind of making the edge of this water fall. Just soften it off there a bit. And it comes down and away. It's quite a bit of dark up there. I'm going to dip into my dark blue as well. Get some blues in there as well as the oranges, orangey colours. Add some more variation to the rocks. Of that, I might just use a little bit of light, a little bit of this reddy colour to break up this edge. A bit more of that red on these rocks here as well, to darken these up. So these are behind this main rock in front. I'll just darken that up a bit. Darker still. At the bottom. Darker marks up here. A few spots of that. That's just a little bit too dark. On my main rock, I'm just going to put a few more tones through it. So I'm going to wet it first with some clean water. In fact, no, I'm going to put some light washes through it first. Sort of a grey purple again. Bit of yellow in there. Gonna bring these as mid-tones around these darker pieces of colour that I've already put on to start to turn the edge and get the rock, give it some more form. I'll darken all that bit up. This front section along that edge a bit. I'm going to put a bit more wash through the top of the rock. Just to help the texture show up of the gesso that's underneath. Get that to show up a bit better. Do the same on this rock. More over here. A bit more tone, I think it needs. Come a bit warmer, so a bit more brown, burnt sienna into that mix. Bring some of this in, bring some of these warmer colours into this rock, perhaps a bit on this one. Bring some more of those warmer colours into this rock here as well. Just make it a bit brighter, stronger. Bit more colour through here. Particularly where it's meeting the water. Just wash that away where it meets the water. Coming down to this section. Put a little bit more tone in my far rocks just to push them back a bit more. So for that I'm going to take some more of the cerulean colours with some slight bit of orange in it just to grey it down, and I'm actually going to wash this over a large section of these rocks to take them down a bit, push them back. I'm going to leave some of the lighter pieces just poking through. This will just be like some kind of shadow cast across them and help unify them. A bit in here. Have some of that on this rock. Into these rocks here. Link those together. Bringing it down that right hand side. And then the rock in the foreground, I'll put a little bit of this same grey wash through this rock. Keeping the this area as light as possible. A bit more of a browny grey at the bottom. Darken that up a bit. And from this side, a bit darker. A few more darks around this rock. And then wash this side out with a bit of the warmer browns. And take that out to where the water is. Develop up the middle section through here, needs to come a bit darker. Again, some more of the browns and greys. So through here it's a bit, needs to come up in tone. Perhaps that's a bit dull, go a bit orangier. A bit more orange. And work this back up into these rocks. And then wash this down, bottom side of that, into the foamy area, coming down into these rocks, which are again more orangey. Wash that away. Darken it up through here a bit. A bit more blue. So the bluey turquoise colours. Some more of those in here. Get those coming round the rocks. Few little marks for the ripples and kind of the direction of the water. Give those a little spray. This right hand side, it's got a bit too dark, so I might just try and lift a bit of colour with some clean water out through here, hoping the gesso will help me lift that off. Some more of these sort of turbulent marks in here. A bit more oranges. A More browns on this side. Just a few more slightly darker marks here and there. A bit bluer. Showing this water cresting over this cliff, well, this edge of the rock. Just want to try and get that feeling of it tipping over the edge there. A bit more orange. A little bit more of the white, and I just want to emphasize a bit more of this water breaking this way. So I'm just going to tap a bit of this white into here whilst it's still moist. Just to get it to turn over that ravine edge. And maybe a little bit more of white just in there, coming from around the corner. There's a few more touches. I'm going to darken up the top section of the water using the Payne's Grey, the transparent yellow, and some of the cerulean. Just to get a bit of this darker water in up here. It needs to tonally come stronger. A, to help the rocks show up and see the path of the water. I just add a bit more colour generally into the painting. So coming round this rock, gonna undulate it through there. Show up the side of this rock, coming round, down, and then it starts to come into our water rushed area. And as I come over to the right, I'm going to just orange it up slightly, put a bit more orange into it. going to come around that boulder, take it right in there, over that edge, and then I start to make my marks, give the suggestion of the water coming down over that edge into the main area of water. Have some few darker green bits in here, so a little bit of green there, just to suggest some rocks underneath that section. And then again, some more green, just to get a bit of continuity in the colours over here. So bringing this water down into our foamy area. It's going to be very foamy around there. And then just a few more greeny marks over here, just to show that the water continues. Over here, show that the water's turbulent coming down there. A few marks there, spray that a bit. Okay, just to finish up then, I'm going to add some other colour accents, just to, I don't know, make the painting a little bit more interesting for me personally. So I'm going to take some purple, and anywhere within the dark that I think I can get away with it, I'm just going to put some of these colours, just to add a bit more vibrancy. Just here and there. A few little detailing marks. A little bit of that purple. And this is fairly dark as well. It's a fairly dry purple, I should say, that I'm putting on. There's not too much water in it. A few more marks here and there. Just to detail up some of these rocks, make some of them stand out more. Blue, I think. So some dark blue now. Marks. That on this side. carve some of these shapes. More of the red, reddy brown. Just do a little bit of a similar trick, this time a slightly lighter colour. Just the indication of maybe a few shapes that possibly are under the water. What's the odd shape around this rock? Darker. Need one or two of those orangier marks on this rock, your little spots. Just the odd warm bit in the background. Just to pick out a couple of notes of warmth. Just finishing up then with some more white. Particularly over this side, I feel like I need a bit more foam in this part of the painting. So I'm just going to bring some of that white in here, just to get this a bit stronger. Perhaps there's a bit more white breaking around these rocks. Try not to be too careful with this and give it some movement. In there. And maybe just the odd bit more there. And then just one more little wash. Fill through this rock just to pick out some more shape, make it a little bit darker. Okay, just want to add one more wash through this rock just to knock it down a bit, it's a bit bright. Too bright back there, I feel. Similarly, this one's a bit bright. Just take those down a tone. Get them to sit back a bit more. And I think with that we are finished. Mm-hmm.